Mr. President, Mrs. Reagan, Judy Resnick, Ron McNair, L. Onizuka, Greg Jarvis, and Chris, I pray that families and friends will remember our pride and our gratitude and find some refuge in its warmth.
We are gathered here today as a family, a common, tragic, and devastating loss. That dream we all possess, Dick, Mike, Judy, Al, O thou, whom we call by various names, approach by several paths, because we need the assurance of a love equally great and wondrous. Daughter, son, colleague, neighbor, and friend, each brings his. We are grateful for the privilege of having known them, having our lives touched by their lives, being bound by ties of love and care. Carriers of thy spirit of love, so that together we may know not only grief, but also the grandeur and the grace of love.
Though the mountains tremble with its tumult, there is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High.
God is with her.
She shall not be moved. God will help her right early. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the chariots with fire. Be still. Know that I am God. I am exalted among the nations, I am exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge.
We come together today to mourn the loss of seven brave Americans, to share the grief that we all feel, us to the family, the friends, and the loved ones of our shuttle astronauts, to those they left behind, the mothers, the fathers, the husbands, and wives, brothers and sisters, and in the way they lost their lives, with dedication, honor, and an unquenchable desire to explore this mysterious and beautiful universe. The best we can do is remember to North Carolina, to Concord, New Hampshire. They were so different, yet in their mission, their quest, they held so much in common. The Vietnamese cross of gallantry with Silver Star, in gratitude from a nation he fought to keep free. We remember Judith Resnick, known as J.R. to her friends. All the Eagle Scout, he said, had helped him soar to the impressive achievements of his career. We remember his dream was to live aboard the space station, performing experiments and playing his saxophone in the weightlessness of space. A teacher not just to her students, but to an entire people, instilling us all with the excitement of this journey we ride into the future. We waited and watched, tried to make sense of what we had seen. That night, I listened to a call-in program on the radio. People of every age spoke of their sadness and the pride they felt of your loved ones. It stirred the soul of our nation. And through the pain, our hearts have been opened to a profound truth. The future is not free. The story of all human progress is one of a struggle against all odds. We learned again that this America, which Abraham Lincoln called the land duty, who gave more than was expected or required, and who gave it little thought of worldly reward. We think back to the pioneers of an earlier century. It doesn't mean the end to the space shuttle program. Every family member I talk to asks specifically that we continue the program, that that is what their departed loved one would want above all else. We will not disappoint. Today we promise to reach out for new goals and ever greater achievements. That is the way we shall commemorate our seven Challenger heroes. Dick, Mike, Judy, Elle, Ron, Sue, knew you well and loved you. The pain will be deep and enduring. A nation, too, will long feel the loss of her seven sons and daughters. May God bless you all and give you comfort in this difficult time.
Please rise and join in the singing of America the Beautiful.